Good morning, everyone. Today, Monday, 6 November 2017. Today, we have ready. Who has medium hair length? สวัสดีเพื่อนๆผมคือประมาณไหล่นะคะยาวประมาณไหล่แต่จะตัดให้สั้นนี่คือ medium hair length.That's good. Well,
coffee this morning or nothing?
Nothing.
Hi, Dory. It's just I forgot to turn my clock back, so I thought it was actually 9:15 when I got here. Well, it was 8:15. About you, but she wanted her hair colored, and I didn't know if you did that.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll let her know. I'll give you her. I'll give her the office number, and she'll call. She wants a color.
The people, they being their own like that.
Okay.
If they did not being, I have my own to give to them. But I don't know if they like.
The color. She has dark black hair. Okay, she must color. She's a little younger than me. She's 48, I think.
Right now, this dark soul.
So I noticed you volunteered down at the secondhand store.
Yeah.
On Wednesday, are you there?
Yeah, just yeah. Wednesday.
Yeah. I usually see you there on Wednesday. You usually, oh, there goes my phone.
Right now, I apply job.
For where?
At retirement. I'm not retirement for home care or cabinet.
Okay.
At they said they have people live there or they pay them 200 up. Patty, what that, you know?
Uh-huh.
Right in there. Are you being resume to them today?
Oh, good. Or you have a busy day then?
Are you sharing my watch battery also? It's
yeah.
On. Oh, okay. It's big, and I will give my resume to them. If I work, if my work start from I think we'll try if they get a job there. The top, the nav, I left T in, will be okay? For the nav, T in, I left it.
Okay.
Western Manitoba's information station, Cube Country, 91.5. It's minus 13 degrees, wind chill minus 23 at 91. I'm Frank McGuire with your information update. The shotgun-toting mystery man who blew a hole in the wall of a branded business has yet to be found. The man entered a downtown business shortly before 10 o'clock Friday night with what appeared to be a shotgun. He did not demand money or goods, but a news release from PBS said he shot a hole in the wall and quickly fled the scene. Police blocked off an area and conducted a search with a canine, but the suspect was not found. Their investigation is ongoing. And Brandon will have a new city manager today. Brandon Mayor Crest, along with members of the city council, will hold a press conference this afternoon at council chambers to introduce the successful candidate. The conference happens at 1 o'clock. Cube Country News will update you on the event as we learn the details. A Brandon woman is behind bars as police say a domestic disturbance call led to her arrest. Police say a 911 call came after a man was assaulted by his common-law partner. The man told police his partner had scratched him and pulled his hair out. PBS says a 19-year-old woman is in custody and released to appear for court in December. Deaths by overdose among Canada's Indigenous population is at an alarming rate. Indigenous drug users are 13 times more likely to die compared with other Canadians. Researcher Dr. Martin Schechter, a professor at the University of BC, says there is a way to decrease the alarming stats.
People who reported more contact with culture and Indigenous culture, right? Attending ceremonies or speaking the native language, those people were more resilient, had less risk than the people who didn't.
A reminder for our listeners in the dog. How long have you been here, April?
In Canada.
No, in this welcome house. Welcome in.
Pop up in Harrison at the Legion Hall, Burton's Parish Hall, and in Russell at the George P. Rosier Lincoln Center. All three breaks run from 1 to 7 p.m.
You get job yet, right now?
No, I'm having a hard time finding a job.
You have to work at the office, right?
At where?
You have to work at the office. Doctor office?
Oh, not yet. No, I wish.
Yeah, that means your job, you need to work there?
Well, I can, with my diploma, I can work in, I don't wish to work at the hospital, but I could. Or a personal care home, or a doctor's office. Yeah, it's really hard to get in. I'd really like to be at Fairview. Have you heard of Fairview? Personal care home? I think it's the biggest one in Brandon. It's a huge, I think it's got like 275 beds.
There.
For the elderly. It's up on 13th, just before you hit Richmond.
Patty. Uh-huh.
They would have health care aides there, but no home care. Well, actually, no, they might have home care in that other part. I think there's some independent living in there,
mm-hmm.
but I think it's separate from the personal care home.
That is your information update on West Man's Voice, Country 91.5.